Your name is Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Your name is Jesus. You are the miracle working God. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Jesus. Your name. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Jesus. Our Father, we return all glory, we return all honor unto you because you are our maker, you are our sustainer, you are our keeper, you are our support. Thank you, O God, for your mercy over our lives. Thank you for bringing us into the month of April. Thank you for the first 3 months in the year 2020. Thank you, despite the turbulence, despite the tumor, despite the crisis, despite the pandemic, Lord, you are watching over us. You are preserving us. You are brooding over us. We celebrate your name, O God, for victoriously bringing us into the month of April. Be thou exalted in the name of Jesus. Father, we have come unto you with our empty vessels. We pray that you will fill us and fill us to the overflow. God, let there be a transformation in the life of every one of us tonight in the name of Jesus. For those who are sick, let there be healing. For those who feel depressed, let there be joy. Let there be liberation. Let every yoke, every bondage over any life tonight be broken in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We worship you, Lord. We give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Praise the Lord. I want to welcome you into the presence of God this evening. It has been by the mercy of God for us to pass through the first 3 months in the year 2020. When we shouted Happy New Year, several of us didn't know what the year was pregnant of. But despite the turbulence, despite the challenges, despite the difficulties, the Lord has been keeping us safe. The Lord Himself has been watching over our lives. The Lord has been preserving us. And for that, we need to really give Him glory. We need to be grateful unto Him because He's our keeper. And it's my prayer that this month of April, this month we shall experience His grace at a higher level in the name of Jesus. We shall experience His lifting in the name of Jesus. Now this month of April, the message God is sending to us, our focus this month is victory. Victory. Victory in Christ Jesus. And so our theme is winning the battles of life through the grace of God. Winning the battles of life through the grace of God. And this 3-day fasting and prayer program, we are going to have our anchor passage in the book of John chapter 1 verse 16 and verse 17. John chapter 1 verses 16 and 17. I read from this end, okay? Now, the Bible says, from the fullness of His grace, we have all received one blessing after another. Verse 17. Now, verse 17. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. While thinking and praying over the issues that are going on in the world today, specifically COVID-19 pandemic, the understanding that began to come to me is we have gotten to a new dispensation in the world. A new chapter is being opened in the agenda of God for the world. And there is every indication that we are the last lap of the end time. For many, many years back, we've been talking about end time, end time, end time. My beloved brethren, the truth, according to the scriptures, in the light of what is happening in the world today, the truth is that we have come to the last lap of the end time. And part of what the Bible had spoken about that will be happening had started happening. And if any one of us is going to survive the challenges that will be following the current event, we will need one thing, and that thing is the grace of God. Hallelujah. COVID-19 pandemic has come to change the way we live permanently forever here on earth. After this pandemic had gone, the world will not remain the same again. The way we'll be living has come to change. And the bad news about this is it will become more difficult to be a true and genuine Christian. It will require the grace of God for me and for you to be able to stand and stand by God and stand by the word of God. And so these 3 days and the entire month of April, our focus will be on grace. It is the grace of God that can grant us victory in all the challenges, in all the troubles, in all the turmoil that the world will be going through in these last days. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to do a little exposition on this passage we have read. Now, while John the Baptist was introducing Jesus unto his audience, now he was telling them that this Jesus, from verse 16, he said, from the fullness of his grace, we have all received one blessing after another. Now, KJV says, we have received grace upon grace. He said, for the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Now, the Bible speaks about John the Baptist, that he was the last prophet to prophesy about the coming of Jesus. And when he was speaking, he said, and from his fullness, we have received. Who was he talking about? He was referring to all the prophets who had risen to prophesy about the coming of Jesus. He was talking about those great men who did great exploits during their generations. He was referring to Noah. He was referring to Abraham. He was referring to Moses. He was referring to Elijah. He was referring to Joshua. He was referring to those great men who did great exploits for God in their own generations. That the secret behind their exploit is the grace of God. Hallelujah. Now, This is not the first time we are going to have crisis in the world. This is not the first time troubles will come in the world. Those men of old, they have faced terrible, terrible troubles, but they were able to survive. And the only secret behind their survival, the only secret behind their success, the only secret behind their breakthrough is the grace of God. So listen to me very well. If you are going to survive, not only this month, but the rest of our days, we need the grace of God. And coming to talk about what is happening currently in the nations of the world, now COVID-19 pandemic is a ravaging problem now. That is not the only problem the people of the world will face. Even when this pandemic is over, the world will be confronted with economic crisis. If you listen to the news, the people in charge of finances have been announcing to the world, our finance minister in Nigeria has been telling the world, the IMF director has been telling the world that, in fact, she said, we have entered recession financially. Now, in Nigeria, the minister of finance is saying, hey, Nigeria has entered recession. That even before the pandemic, Nigeria was having a home problem. But now the COVID-19 pandemic has now really aggravated the whole situation. And as I began to think about it, what was coming to my mind is, in the next 3 months, 4 months, 5 months in Nigeria, will our state governors or state governments be able to pay salary as and when due? Will they be able to pay salary regularly? Will Nigerians not enter into trouble again economically? Will even the federal government be able to pay salary as and when due? I perceive that we need the grace of God. And for this 3-day fasting and prayer program, we are looking at this grace.